Let us see how Swarf Finishing will help you to generate toolpath by selecting multiple surfaces without creating any boundaries. So though this Swarf Finishing and Surface Finishing dedicatedly using for 5-axis toolpath strategies, but still you can use it for a 3-axis application. In this example, I would like to create a toolpath for this particular surface and on the opposite side having two other surfaces. For this, it is not necessary to create boundaries. Just simply select multiple surfaces wherever you would like. Try to do it on vertical surfaces. It won't apply for horizontal surfaces when particularly coming for 3-axis application. Select your Swarf Finishing. So here you can select the Swarf Finishing. You can select side as outside along that. These are all default options. So only thing you would need to change the cut direction. Select the surface and preview it whether it is working correct. So you can see able to see here. So it is generating the toolpath here. Come to the multiple cuts option. Here I'm using offset up. If you create off here, so you can able to see what is happening here. So you can only able to create a single toolpath at the bottom. There is no multiple cuts here. You can able to see it is very clear, and it is you can able to generate the toolpath very fast without creating any boundaries. Only I'm selecting multiple surfaces here. As I said earlier, it is applicable for vertical walls only. In the tool axis page, you must select vertical here instead of automatic. And now come back to the multiple cuts page. You can see how multiple modes are available. See, off is actually only one pass at the bottom of the surface. Offset down means you can able to calculate this toolpath and you can understand how it works. If you say offset down, so whatever the surface at the upper side, it will generate in the same flow actually. For this case, it won't work. So you can select offset up. So because the offset up means it will generate the toolpath based on the surface shape at the bottom actually. Okay, so it is straight line, so I would like to generate the same. If you calculate the toolpath again here, you can able to see a beautiful toolpath comes in play. So here you can see now it is cut exactly with the surface, it won't touch other surfaces. At the same time, you can able to generate for multiple surfaces also. So this will mostly helps you generate the toolpath, particularly when you are coming in a picture where you want to do some touch up for a particular surfaces. This will create very simple and it is in a faster manner.